Well, the first week entailed the consultation with the department, the officials in the department, and then it started to extend to the stakeholders. Mm-hmm. And that's where we are now. We're interacting with the stakeholders. We're meeting with the heritage family, all the agencies and institutions of heritage. We also were meeting with an important body, the Federation of Cultural and Creative Arts Industry, which I think is going to help in representing a united and coordinated voice of people from the industries.
What is your sense of, I know it's only been a week, but what is your sense of this industry, this arts and culture sector? What feeling are you getting from it?
Well, it's a broad area of work, very broad, and has challenges. But I think that with working diligently in what has been put in place over 2 decades, would be able to tackle some of the things which are some perennial problems, if you like, in the industry, which affect the industry across the board.
What is at the top of your list? You know, the industry is not always in agreement, but at the top of the list that I would think would be funding.
Well, the top of the list would be, first and foremost, getting more coordinated and organized. I think that would be, because through that to be able then to look at specific needs. There are very specific needs. If you talk of artists, for instance, people were raising with us recently the whole issue of their welfare, the whole issue of how their products are treated, particularly local products in broadcasting circles and so on. But also a sense of security. Someone was saying that there are areas like domestic work which are a bit organized now, and you know, processes toward their security, particularly employment-wise, and all that goes with it, be the issues of pension and all those things, they are getting somewhere. So it means here also that can happen. So it's a variety of things. It's things like that. But generally, the overarching issue is the whole issue of social cohesion. That if we use that program effectively, we'll be able to achieve what is expected of us, of ensuring that there is South African identity. Mm-hmm. Right now, people speak from different corners of our society, but we need to endeavor to have this thing or these things which, you know, characterize us as South Africans. That will start, of course, from the very young age, at the level of basic education. If you steep people in the values, especially as a constitutional democracy, constitutional values of our society, we will be able to have something and say this identifies us as South Africans.
You said you're meeting with stakeholders. Do those stakeholders include the National Lotteries Board and the National Arts Council? And are you at a point where you can get these two organizations who literally work for the same organization, but they seem to have two different functions?
Well, you are quite correct. One thing you can't miss when you get in contact with this portfolio is the fragmentation across the board. And what is good is that currently the review on the white paper is on. One of the things which is being raised is the streamlining and rationalization of the industry, so that you have that coordinated, as I said earlier on, that coordination becomes important. There are agencies and structures. Perhaps we are making an example there. You also go to heritage, where you see that here we're supposed to be having one structure, so that whatever you do is more effective than the silos which you find in the air. And I'm sure with time we'll be able to correct that. And yes, to your question, we are meeting stakeholders across the board, and part of what we'll be doing will be looking into the mechanisms to be effective in what we are doing, and not talking from different corners.
And of course, that's the new